marketing mindset, where each week, members of the Agency Sparks team dive into discussions on industry trends, marketing tips, and helpful resources for marketers. If you'd like to see previous episodes of The Marketing Mindset, you can go find Agency Sparks on YouTube or visit agencysparks.com/marketingmindset. All right, let's get started with today's topic, which is how to market to marketers. Consumers are not always marketers, but marketers are always consumers. We chose this topic because there are a lot of new MarTech or marketing technology innovations entering the industry every day. And this means in the near future, there will be more marketers struggling to navigate the challenge of marketing to marketers. And the way marketers view an advertisement is just fundamentally different than the average person. So how do they view that advertisement? If you Google how to market to marketers, you're going to find not very much. There's not a whole lot of insights or empirical data. And if this isn't the first time you've heard of Agency Sparks, you're probably already aware that because our business model is all about connecting brands and marketing agencies, we spend a lot of time thinking about how to market to marketers. If there's one thing I want you to take away from this video, it's this. The main advantage of marketing to marketers is that you're speaking to an audience that understands and appreciates the challenges of marketing. So a well-executed marketing campaign will get a lot more respect and recognition from a marketer than it would from the average consumer. But that recognition is a double-edged sword. Because marketers understand what goes on behind the scenes, they are far more critical of poorly executed campaigns. So, when it comes to personalization, one huge advantage of marketing to marketers is that they understand the mechanics of what goes into targeted ads. They are far less likely to get creeped out by that retargeted ad that follows them from site to site. They appreciate the personalization. However, there's a caveat to this. No marketer will ever think, wow, this brand really gets me, just because you use their first name in the subject line of an email. So the good news, you can go all in on the creepiness. The bad news, you have to put in a little bit of extra effort if you really want to wow them. So, messaging. When it comes to the messaging of a campaign for marketers, you have to put yourself in their shoes because that's what they do every day in their jobs. They're constantly using empathy to put themselves in the shoes of their target market. So they appreciate having the same done for them. Marketers also appreciate authenticity, and they can see through those unsubstantiated claims that so many brands make in their advertisements. Because marketers are familiar with persuasive techniques like scarcity, reciprocity, social proof, etc., they know how to spot an ad that's trying to spin their product in a misleading way using messaging as the tool. It may be scary to lay your cards out on the table like that, but it goes a long way in building trust with marketers. And lastly, just keep it brief. You have a smaller window of opportunity to get your message across, so use that time well. So, creative. When it comes to creative, marketers know that there is no magic formula for success. So therefore, marketers spend a lot of time examining creative through a different lens. This is good because once you catch a marketer's eye, you'll have their attention, mostly because they want to look at the details, the color scheme, the typography, the imagery. They'll want to ask themselves, you know, why did this catch my eye? The flip side of this is that marketers hold creative to a higher standard. To marketers, creative is art, and when it comes to marketing, they're the toughest art critics out there. So when designing the creative, you have to really make sure to strike the balance between simplicity and substance, as well as the balance between subtlety and clarity. And finally, building loyalty with marketers. It's kind of the same as any other consumer, but you know, it's really important to build trust through transparency and providing value. The only difference is that marketers just have an above average BS radar. They can spot the difference between a brand engaging in corporate social responsibility and a brand that's hashtag hijacking a cause just to make a quick buck. So you can't really just throw money at a poorly crafted campaign and hope to buy their loyalty. Marketers' loyalty has to be earned. So creating high quality content, offering free resources, and offering rewards for their loyalty goes a long way. So that's it for today. We'd love to hear your thoughts on this subject, so please let us know if you have any other tips for marketing to marketers in the comments. We'll post a link to the full blog on this topic in the comments as well, and you can subscribe to our blog by visiting agencysparks.com/preferences. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next week.